Nice to meet all of you. My name is Vibeke Kolbe, as Jes mentioned. I have been with Bavarian Nordic for coming up to 12 years. And before that, I've been a management consultant for a number of years for companies like Novo, but mostly actually in England for Shang Plow and Gillette, Duracell and so on. In Bavarian Nordic, I am the head of project office, which of course is owning the project portfolio management system among a few others. So I'm happy to take you through what our thoughts were on selecting a system, why we needed it and what it has given us. And also towards the end, a little bit of food for thoughts on what to do and maybe what not to do, depending on our own experience.
Sounds good. Unfortunately, the camera doesn't work with Vibeke, but I hope you can.
Yeah, I'm sorry, I dropped my computer, so it's very low tech that it doesn't work. Not to take you through Bavarian Nordic's vision and strategy, but just to explain that we are aspiring to be the largest pure-play vaccine company, and we are focusing on innovating life-saving vaccines, also within, for instance, cancers. We are researching cancer vaccines, and then, as some of you in Denmark would have known, is that we've just entered a contract on the COVID vaccine, which is going into to the later stages early next year. So we aspire to be best-in-class vaccine manufacturer on the pure play vaccine, and are focusing on establishing a full-scale commercial operation. In the past, BN hasn't had a commercial product. We've been supplying and developing vaccines mainly for preventive, like Ebola and yellow fever, for instance, the American government and other governments as well. But we have now Rabipur and Encepur, and also our smallpox vaccine on the market. So that has been over here the last 2 years. It's been a transformation of BN from being a strictly bio company researching and development now into a pharma company, not only researching, but also producing over-the-counter medicines or vaccines.
And this is just... Oh, sorry, Vibeke, just a quick question. The Ebola, is it possible to vaccine people against that?
Vaccine is a funny thing. Vaccine isn't, in layman terms, a lot of people believe that vaccine means that once you've been vaccinated, then it lasts forever. I think a lot of people during COVID has experienced that it's not that, and it's the same with Ebola. So with the Ebola, it's not a lifetime vaccine, which copper, for instance, is. But yes, you can actually go in and prevent Ebola outbreaks, which is the vaccine that we have. But you can't go down to the counter and buy an Ebola vaccine yet. We are the ones we're producing, we are storing, and then we can send them off to the areas where we have outbreak. So we don't expect everybody on the planet to be vaccinated against Ebola. But if there's an outbreak, then the vaccine goes straight down to those areas and can immediately help. Help. So that's how it's going to be used.
Okay.
Bavarian Nordic are placed in, we are Hellerup, we have finance, IT and HR. Then in Zug is this new, as I just mentioned, our commercial organization. In Martinsried, Germany, we have a R&D, but also some QC labs. And in Kvistgaard is where all our manufacturing is taking place. So therefore also our supply chain. So both drug substance and drug product. And then in the US, we have in North Carolina, a smaller entity of regulatories. And the reason why I'm sharing this with you is for you to understand the complexity that we have in our project office, is that we are actually serving project throughout the entire organization. So throughout countries abroad and in Denmark, we have at any given time plus 90 projects. Moment we're running at 136, I just checked this morning. But in principle, we are seeing a project manager is generic. We have competences that makes us excellent project managers. But whether we run a project in research or whether we run a project in production or in HR, could be legal contingency plans or in quality, the task for the project manager, the tools are identical. Then, of course, there could be different project plans. If it's a clinical trial versus a budget that needs to be updated, but it's the same kind of tools and philosophy behind it, which is also why Bavarian has decided to have all project managers placed in one area. Then we have project coordinators who we don't have as many expectations to and have as much responsibility. Then, of course, we have project managers that might have more insight into IT than maybe necessarily into production. But in principle, we are all project managers with the competency sets that is the same. So in Project Office, our vision strategy can be boiled down to that we want to make sure that Bavarian are working on the right projects at the right time with the right goals. So back to how can we have 90 projects in organization where we are just below 1,000 employees. Hence, we need to ensure that we can be the partner to the management on which project to start and which project to put on hold, or maybe even to stop. And this was some of the challenges that we were having in our project office before we partnered up with Projectum. So our challenge back in 2022 was that we were missing a portfolio overview. We were having Excel sheets, as I'm sure some of you have remembered to have, where all the projects were listed. There was a poor communication to upper management on which project to prioritize and how they were going. There was little ownership of who is the project owner, who's the, we knew who the project manager was, but who's the steering group members. And then lastly, we also lacked a standardized project approach. The GATE model is in place, but how do we report back to the steering group? Or how do we report on the risks and et cetera? For us at least, it was dependent on each project manager. We didn't have a common tool. So what we aimed for and what we have achieved now and is working on together with Projectum on a version 2.0 is what I'm going to go through and show you in just highlights. We were looking for and believe that we've got a project portfolio system that shows us visibility, that shows us what's deliverable, what are the planned versus actual costs, what are the benefits that we're getting and how do we ensure that we're getting them, that we have control of the projects, that we can allocate the right resources and actually also that we're utilizing the resources in the most optimal way. We have efficient projects because they're very capacity planned now. We can prioritize which projects go first. So for instance, when a COVID vaccine comes into play, not within the hour, but fairly soon, we can recommend to the director of our board, which projects are we going to put on hold and which one are going to continue with, and how is that going to affect our overall strategy. And then we have an even further clear governance, project structure, people know where to look for the status. And in a company like ours, that is still have a lot of bio development research in our gene, the different scenarios can quickly be visualized in our PPM. And it, again, it helps the senior management to make the right calls on how to move forward. Regarding the PPM, how we decided to select to join or to have a projectum at our partner, for us at least, could be very different from you, is that we wanted a system that was simple. And it's so important for us that we weren't first movers, that we had a simple system that could be easily trained and used. We didn't want any adaptions, so we wanted to make sure that whenever there's updates from Projectum, that they will automatically be integrated. So we didn't want to have specialties that doesn't link into to the automated further development, continuous development that that Projectum has. We have some criteria for the company. So we were looking for a partner who was like BN, dedicated, showed agility, and had a vision for excellence in their genes. We wanted them to make sure that we chose a partner who had a solid business understanding. So we didn't have to explain what is a certain terminology or what is BN doing. We wanted somebody who could work with us from the go-get. And then we wanted somebody who was friendly, professional. Sounds funny, but for me, it was very important that I liked the person that we were working with. And it has proven over again that because we like each other and because we want this to be a success, there's so many things that can easily be handled just over the phone. Even now with COVID, we haven't met with Projectum once since COVID started, but everything is running smoothly and there's a clear communication path. So don't underestimate those criteria. And then thirdly, we wanted to use somebody who had references that we could talk to. We were not focusing on life science industry because we wanted also to learn from other industries who had what problems were they facing and how did a system overcome those. And given these criteria, we talked to different companies. Also abroad from Denmark, so that wasn't part of our selection, that the company had to be Danish based. But we chose Projectum for four reasons. The vision helped companies to reach their goals, and that is so critical for BN, that we have a partner who wants BN to be a success. Their solutions are simple and straight away usable. The guidance are clear. It's quick to address if we don't understand something. They pick up the phones immediately. They take the time to understand. We had a funny thing about what is a KPI, a key performance indicator, and we had one version of it, and Projectum have heard a different. It's just finding out, okay, what do you mean by this terminology? And then they understood. And for some reason, they spread it out to their team. I didn't even have to remind them. And then everybody was on board. Okay, for BN, KPI performance is this. So that was really, very positive. And as I said before, they're nice professional people. If we have an agreement, they call back. If they have a problem or sickness or something and can't meet, they give us a shout and we work around that. So that's why we chose Projectum, and we are happy with that choice and will continue to develop. But I'll come back to what we are working with Projectum on going forward. So how has the PPM system, Power PPM, helped us in our goals? So we have now the portfolio, professional portfolio. One of the other things we were after was the effective communication. And what we got, what PowerPoint have given us, is simply clear dashboards. And in two dashboards, we have the perfect, in our view, overview of our projects, and they can then be drilled down whether we want an overall or division, whether we want individual projects, etc. And these dashboards are giving us what we want on a daily basis. We're using them on our project boards, which we have in each division. When the board of directors throw, for instance, a COVID at us, then we can merge and into this and saying, what, how is that going to affect? So these dashboards have changed our outlook. And we have focused on our stage gate model. So it's showing us how is the spread of our, and these are live pictures, sorry, by the way. So this is how is our projects, or how many do we have across the different gates? So you could argue we have a lot of things going on at the moment. Maybe we should have more even spread. That's something I'm working on. Regarding the finance, we are using the S-curve. But again, it's simple, easy system, and Projectum made it work for what's how we want to look at the numbers, in how many details or not. There is a key performance indicators per project. Again, it gives a clear overall, it's sorting how you want it. Stage gate details on each of the project, this is summed up, but this is per project. On the second page, we have our resource overview, we have critical milestones, and we have the risk. Again, it can be brought into overall division department. We've also created different portfolios depending if you have a research view or if you want to have a production review. This system allows you to shape the overviews how you want to use them in different situations. Then the next issue we had was our accountability. And the PPM system have helped us to move from, I'm going to be a little bit bold and said that we were in, this is the project, go do, and we do it. And now we can actually recommend solution, make sure that we routinely overview and we support our senior management into what it is that we should focus on or who is responsible for what. Do we have a division that has too many projects in a certain stage? How do we do with that? So again, it's giving us this accountability across the company that has helped us in our daily life, going back and forward between the pharma industry and the bio, which can be very challenging for a company like ours. And then lastly, the standardization. Currently, we have 32 project managers, and they use the same platform. If it's an engineer manager, project manager, or whether it's an IT manager, again, we have the same focus and the same kind of reporting. So any manager going into the system can understand whatever project I am in the steering group for. This is the overview. This is how I read it. We have a set on how to, when something is red, then what does that mean? With something in yellow, what does that mean? So these standards, the PPM system has helped us to make them firm, make sure that they were communicated clearly. So we are all looking at the same words and the same way of expression, no matter where the project is based. And that has been a huge benefit. And whether that's on the status, on the timelines, financial risks, minute, stakeholder analysis, no matter where you are, the platform looks the same. The slides are the same. So we have the same understanding of what we're seeing on the screen. And then, of course, we have a little place where the project managers can give explanations that might be relevant for the individual stages on this and so on the others. So the individuality that is required for each of the project from the project managers goes into there was created space for it in the slides or in the dashboards from Prosectum. So before I move into what's next for BN and project portfolio, is there any questions so far?
I think the format is going to be difficult.
Okay.
To get questions to you, but Vibeke, I was thinking, what if after today that somebody has a question, could I send you an email if that happens?
Yes, please. Or you can put my email on the slides when you share the slides with the participant, and they can contact me directly. Whatever works.
Yes,
that's perfectly fine.
Do that. Yes.
So what's next for BBN? For BN on the PPM scene. We are right now finalizing our first tool that's going to be our steering group presentations. So basically up here in the left-hand corner, this is our manual PowerPoint slide, because all the presentations for all the steering groups are the same. So it's manual, and you click and you paste, and you dump screen, etc. What Prosectum is doing for us now is that you press a button, more or less, and then it generates the picture or the status you have from the PPM system. So it's going to be far more simple for our project managers in future to go in and create steering group presentations, project team meetings, stakeholder updates, etc. So that's some of the things that the system can be used for. And that again will generate the standardization and the common understanding to BN. And it's going to help us very much, because we have started a yearly training for our work package owners, functional leads, and steering group members, department heads, on what it is to be part of a project, depending on role. And the PPM system will help us making sure that these trainings are even more relevant for what they're going to be experiencing as part of their role. So that's going to be very exciting and the natural next step for BN. Some food for thoughts. I just want to encourage you not to underestimate the change management when implementing a PPM system. Depending on what basis you have now, we came from an Excel sheet, and having it into a system that does what you tell it to also have some challenges, because it's telling you what to prioritize when maybe you know you should prioritize differently coming up with a strategy. So it requires some rethinking of in the change management area of how to ensure that all the management is aboard. When using the team planner, which BN also is using, make sure you find committed ambassadors within the line management. One thing is that I think it's great and it's really helping me in my work, and I can see where it can help my line managers. They need to use the system, to see the system, to live it before they see the benefits. And you know how it is in a busy world. Maybe not all is eager to spend an hour a month, is what our line management is doing on an average, and before they see what they can get of it. So just hold their hand, and I'm sure they'll get on board. When talking to Prosectum or any company like Prosectum, make clear when you specify your report. One thing that Prosectum also learned us is that if I were talking one language, my colleague maybe thought differently, and we hadn't aligned when we met Prosectum. So we had some workshops where Prosectum led us through these exercises. So that's really good that you get it down on paper, drawings, etc., on what is it that we actually want to achieve. I think by doing that with Prosectum, they saved us a lot of time in discussing back and forward and just getting a clear picture from the get-go. And also, Prosectum have a lot of ideas and experiences, and I'm not just saying this because we're using them, but I've really found the bouncing and the partnership of, and I'm sure it could be with other companies as well, but Projectum have really stepped up and says, Vibeke, you are not asking for this, you're actually asking for this when I listen to your needs, etc. So they're challenging me, and they're challenging me, remember, Vibeke, you want it simple, what you're doing now is not simple. And that has really saved me time and struggles. So thank you for Projectum. But again, some to you all, use them because they're doing it every day. And I'm at least I'm not developing a portfolio every day. So I just have some ideas and thoughts of my needs, and I use them as partners to get where I need to be in a 6 months time. So those were my thoughts.
Thank you.
I wanted to share with you.
Yeah. I think it's going to be difficult to have questions coming in, but then let's share your email and contact data in the end and grab it as a PDF.
Please.
And then the audience can contact Vibeke on your liking. I had one question, Vibeke. On a more critical item, why is it so difficult to involve line managers in resource management? I know it's a generic question, but
but it's very relevant. It's like you remember. I don't know if you've seen the drawing of some people from the Stone Ages looking at the round wheel and saying, "Oh, we don't have time to use that," and they're still using the square wheel. So it's about finding time to realize that this will save you time. It's that classic that they we'll just continue with what we have now, even though spending half a day learning something new, and they will actually save time in the long run. And in BN, they just don't have time for that. And therefore, we've decided from January that I'm going to be spending, sounds tedious, but I believe it's worth the effort, an hour with each of these ambassadors that I've identified, and making sure that they're going in, that they're utilizing the system. And then I strongly believe within 3 or 4 times, then they're on their own, they understand the system and they can see the benefits, and then the word is going to spread. That's how we're done with the rest of the PPM. That's what we'll do with this as well.